So now we're going to look at generic deltas. See, what is the T code for creating generic extractor? RSO2. Yeah. But look at this. Now what I'm doing is I'm not using ECC as a source. I'm using BW as a source for BW, for just showing you demo on generic delta bus. Because even in BW, I'll have RSO2. Because my clocks will be synchronized in the server. Because R3 and BW may not be synchronized. Just for in the real time, it's fine. Same thing what I'm doing it here, you would do in ECC bus. No difference. Okay, na? So what I'm doing, I'm using the same BW system to enable, show you demo on generic delta. So in that case, what connections will I use? Will I use R3 connection or will I use myself connection? I use my, that's the only difference, otherwise everything else is same, okay? First let me explain you what is what. So when you're creating generic extract, okay? There's some table like this. Now when you're going, how do you specify delta? And click on this here. Generic delta. Here. See? Don't worry on this. You can say what type, what should be your mechanism of delta, timestamp or what? Date wise or numeric pointer. And when you specify any of the type, you specify on which field should I use for it. Suppose let's say I say ER dat, which is what? Date. Then I'll say delta is on. Delta should work with based on date wise and using which field? This field. Atla. What mechanism you want and based on which field it has to work. That's the concept. That's it. Okay. But what, how does it work when you say cal day? How does it work when it timestamp? How does it work numeric point? We'll see. Okay. Okay, boss. Let's say here I've got a table like something. Z sales is my table name. I've got a field like VBLN, let's say year dat, NETWR, some currency, let's say some sales or. Okay, let's say this is my table in this, and I give you some type. This is my database. So now I clearly tell you that this table is going to be a sales table, and each record in this table is basically a sales order. Each record in it indicates one sales order. Now every time there is a new sales order, a new transaction is, happens, you go to create a new order, and every order would get a new increment number. Let's say now order number is 1, 2, 3, right? The next order would be 4, and the next order would be 5, 6. That's how it comes. Okay. Okay, boss. Now what I want to do is I want to say, so based on the document number, can I say this is a new record or old record? Now you got document number 1, 2, 3. Okay. Later tomorrow I come in, I see 4. I can I say the 4 was created newly? So with the help of number, I am going to say. So in that case, when you want to set up delta based on a column, which is basically giving a new incremental number, we go with numeric pointer. What I'll do, I'll create a data source on this table and enable delta on which field, which is this VBLN field. That is, see, that is field name. Data delta specific field is what? VBLN. And what type of delta? I'll say NP. I'm enabling delta on the data source on this table. What type of delta it is? Numeric pointer. And what is the delta relevant field? VBLN. So when you say numeric pointer, it works with the incremental number. Okay. Now look. Now same way, let's say you have some infobix in BW. Can I have infobix with the same name? With the same infobix, let's say created in BW, and he was asking me, when I'm doing generic extension, should I create infobix? Yes. If you're bringing data source of 5 fields, obviously you should have 5 infobix to map those, right? Yeah. Let's say, I know these are like field names. Can I have infobix with the same field name? Yeah, no issues here. Let's say I have a cube like this. Okay? And you performed a data flow, data source to target, everything is done. So you go and trigger this. You want to trigger what? Info package. So I'm going to trigger my info package with what update? If your info package supports delta, first time when you see, do you get to see full and init both? If data source supports delta, in the info package, do you get to see two update options? One is full and init both. So I'll see info package with what? Initialize delta. What is the difference between full and init? If I don't run initialize, can I do delta next one? So if I need to do a delta from next, I need to first run what? Initialize the data source. Initialize delta update. From next, I can start running what? Delta update. Now when I do initialize, how does it work? If I do initialize, how does it work?
It prints full
data.
What
is it? It prints all the data. It works like full. Yeah. So what happens? How many records should come in? All the 3 records will come into BW. So your init is done. Yeah. As soon as you run init, it extracts all the data from the full update also works same way. So what does initialize do? It extracts all the historical data and puts into my target in BW. Another put data source, then you run DDP. Okay. Then what it does? Once your init is successful, it extracts all the historical data, then it sets up a delta status. Delta status and pettukuntundi. Okay. Eppudu, as soon as you run the init, it extracts all the historical data to BW. And starts maintaining the delta status, saying like this, delta status, what is delta relevant field? VBLN. What is the pointer till where it is extracted? 3. That is called as delta status. And you can see this delta status in the T code RSA 7. RSA 7 T code lo, delta status chudachman, kotnaka 3 and dupis. Okay. Then later you come back. So once you run init, can I keep running delta every day?
Yes.
Or every hour depending on the record. Let's say now I create new order. Okay. You create some new orders. So from morning to evening, let's say they have performed some transactions where they could only create what? 2 orders. Then then from next onwards, every day you run init only once in your lifetime. Then you keep running delta loops. Now what is info package? I'll run delta loops. Okay. So when you run the delta, what it does? It gets to the source ECC and finds out your delta status. What is the delta status here? 3. So then it extracts all the records greater than 3, takes these 2 records 4 and 5. And goes to the source and updates my status as what? 5. Again, let's say you create some more transactions. Yeah. Okay. Again, once you run delta, every day you will be running delta loads. No? It could be hourly or daily, weekly, depending on requirement. So when I do delta again, next what happens? Again, the status is 5 and it picks up all the records greater than 5, which is what? 6, 7, and 8, and takes it to your target and updates this delta status as what? 8. This is how delta works. Any doubt? Look at this. It says, if you are doing a mechanism with this numeric pointer, you are able to recognize the new record what is created. Suppose say I change this to, let's say, 88. Are you recognizing this? That is the problem with numeric pointer. So numeric pointer is enabled delta on a field which is like counter like field. So it will only recognize the new records what is created. It does not recognize the records what is being changed. Right? Accepted. That is how numeric pointer works. So that's why you must use a numeric pointer delta only in a scenario or a table where there is always a creation of new record. There is never a change of record. There will be some tables like that. Say there could be some scenario like say cats deep, you know, table in them. HR. Time management table. That will one record marade. Every time it will be a new record. There might be some scenario where there is never a creation of new record. In those cases, numeric pointer could be an option of enabling delta. That's the option. But I am not saying that is the only option. This is one option of enabling delta. Numeric pointer. Clear? Okay. Did you understand what numeric pointer was? Yes. Okay, boss. Next, as he said, if I am using numeric pointer, I am not recognizing the documents what is changed, but I have a scenario of a table where the change of a document is also possible and even that has to be captured. So, the numeric pointer option is ruled out. Boss. Then what I will do, I will go with the next kind of delta mechanism where I have an option of CalDev. Okay. So, now look at this here. Now I'll explain to you about a table. I have a field called date of tran under this. Date of transaction. This will have when the document is initially created, it will have the created date. When you keep changing it, it will have the changed date. If now this was initially created on 20th April. Let's say on the next day I change it on 22nd. So this date will get modified as 22nd April 2015 and mark. Atma endante ee date em untundante if it is a new record created, it will have the created date. If it is modified, it will have the date of modification. So now by looking at this date values, can I know on which date this particular transaction has been modified or created? Ee date column batti ee date values batti idi ee roju kottaga create ayinda లేదు మాడిఫై అయినా కనుక్కోగలుగుతాను అప్పు ఎందుకు కనుక్కోవచ్చు ఆ డేట్ కాలంలో ఏముంటుంది ఇఫ్ ద రికార్డ్ ఇస్ న్యూలీ క్రియేటెడ్ ఇట్ లేవ్ ది క్రియేటెడ్ డేట్ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ చేంజ్ ఇట్ లేవ్ ది చేంజ్ డేట్ అప్పుడు ఈ కాలం బేస్ ఆన్ ద వాల్యూస్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ కాలం డేట్ కెన్ ఐ రికగ్నైజ్ దట్ దిస్ ఇస్ బీన్ మాడిఫైడ్ ఆర్ న్యూలీ క్రియేటెడ్ ఎస్ అనుకో సో కెన్ ఐ ఇంప్లిమెంట్ లాజిక్ ఆఫ్ ఐడెంటిఫైంగ్ ది డెల్టా రికార్డ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ కాలం Yes, possibility. So I will say what? I will say delta relevant field is what? Date of transaction and the delta mechanism is CalDate date wise. When you want to enable the delta mechanism based on the date wise, I would use CalDay and the delta relevant field is what? Date of transaction. Done. I have enabled like this. Now again I created data source on this table with cal date delta by using which field? Data transaction is all fine. Now again you replicated connected data source, target transformations, info package, DTP, everything is ready. Let's say I start doing it again. Again you will start running init now. So when I start running init, now let's say now today's date is what? April 22nd, okay. So when I run the init, what happens? Today's date is 22nd. It extracts all the records where my the date of transaction, because delta is on date of transaction, right? Less than what? 22nd April 2015, current date. And how many records comes in? It is not like me. Format margin. Okay, it will extract these three records and loads into what? To BW, and we will update the data status as what? Date of, what is the delta relevant field? Date of TRAN, 22nd April 2015. Okay, Ramesh? Let's say now 22nd date ipindi, rose ipindi. Let's say the next day started, 23rd has started. Then you start modifying this record 23.01, sorry, not 0, 04.2015. You modified this from 88 to let's say 99. And then you also create one more new record, 4, say 23rd, 04, 2015 with 9 INR 1/3. Now when you do delta, now once you finish it, you keep running what? Let's say from 23rd morning till evening, they basically created one new record and they modified one existing record. At night and then evening of 23rd, you're trying to extract the data. Okay, extract what will you perform? Delta. So when you run the delta, what happens? It takes the previous delta status as a lower limit and the current date as the upper limit. Then the criteria would be extract all the records from the table where date of transaction is greater than the lower limit. Lower limit is what? Previous delta, 22nd, and less than or equal to my current date. When is it? 23rd. Tell me how many records. So look at my condition. Greater than my lower limit and less than or equal to upper limit. Upper limit at current date. Current date is what? 23rd April. So what records will it pick up? Greater than 22nd but less than or equal to 23rd. So what records will it pick up? and greater than 22nd undali, less than 23rd undali, rendu undali. And so what is it? Will it pick up this record? Let's say I'll overwrite this record. Do you know how to overwrite bus? How will you override? If it is given changed value, I must override by using what? ODS. Now it extracts 4th record also. And it will update the status to what? Okay. Let's say again on the next day. Next day started, 24th has started. They have created one more record. What will be date? Valid. Again there is one record changed, there is one record I created newly. Let's say again from 24th morning till evening they process the transactions in the business. In the night again I need to take it to BW bus. Again when I do delta, what is the criteria bus now? Lower limit is 23rd, upper limit is you are running it on evening 24th. So what is the criteria bus? Greater than 23rd and less than or equal to what? 24th. So what documents will it pick up? Will it pick up the 5? I know, because it is giving me change value, I must overwrite by using what? ODS. This is how delta works on CalDev. Any issues here? Even a problem out there?
Difficult to find out
what you want to find out. నువ్వేం చేయలేదు అప్పుడు సిస్టమ్ కదా, వై యువర్ వరీడ్? వాట్ ఆర్ ద లాజిక్ ఐఎమ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్? వీ విల్ నాట్ డూ దట్. సిస్టమ్ విల్ ఐడెంటిఫై దట్. సో యూఆర్ గివింగ్ లాజిక్ టు సిస్టమ్. యూ డోంట్ వరీ ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ కాంప్లెక్స్. హౌ మెనీ టైమ్స్
ద కస్టమర్ హస్ చేంజ్ ద రిక్వెస్ట్ విచ్ ఇస్ డిఫరెంట్?
యూ కెన్ గెట్ ద ఎంటైర్ హిస్టరీ ఇన్ ఓడిఎస్ చేంజ్ లాగ్. ఇన్ ద ఓడిఎస్ చేంజ్ లాగ్ విల్ గివ్ మీ ఎంటైర్ చేంజెస్ ఆఫ్ ది ట్రాన్సాక్షన్. దెన్ ఇంకేం ప్రాబ్లం లేదా? ఇంకా కొత్తది ఏదన్నా? బట్ ఇంకా రీజనింగ్ నాకు కావాలి. ఇట్స్ నాట్ జస్ట్ లుక్ అట్ దిస్, లుక్ అట్ మై ప్రాబ్లమ్. సో ఆన్ 24th యు రన్ దిస్ లోడ్. అట్ వాట్ టైమ్ డిడ్ యు రన్? లెట్స్ సే ఇట్స్ ఈవినింగ్ 7 o'clock ఆర్ 8 o'clock. ఆన్ ద సేమ్ డే ఆఫ్టర్ యు రన్ ద డెల్ లోడ్ అట్ 8 o'clock, లెట్స్ సే నైట్ 10 o'clock దేర్ ఇస్ వన్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ క్రియేటెడ్, వాట్ విల్ బి డేట్? ఓకే, ఆన్ ద సేమ్ డే నైట్ ఆఫ్టర్ యూ డన్ ద లోడ్ అట్ 8 o'clock, ఐ క్రియేట్ దిస్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ అట్ నైట్ 10 o'clock. లెట్స్ నెక్స్ట్ డే స్టార్ట్ అట్ 25th, 7:25 ఐ క్రియేట్ వన్ ట్రాన్సాక్షన్. ఓకే, సో లెట్స్ యూ రన్ అగైన్ ఆన్ 25th ఈవినింగ్, యూ రన్నింగ్ ద లోడ్ అట్ 8 o'clock. What is it, what will be criteria was? What is the lower limit? 24. What is higher limit? 25. So greater than 24, less than or equal to 25th. So what happens? Only 7th is brought in, 6th is not considered. Why? Did you understand the problem? How can I solve this problem? అట్లా సో దెర్ ఈస్ అ ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ మిస్సింగ్ సమ్ డెల్టా రికార్డ్స్ లైక్ దిస్, రైట్? అప్పుడు మిస్ కాకూడదంటే ఏం చేయాలి? ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ నాట్ సపోజ్ టు మిస్ రికార్డ్స్ లైక్ దిస్, వాట్ హౌ విల్ యూ సాల్వ్ ఇట్? టైం పెట్టుకోవాలి సరే, డేటే ఉందనుకో, అప్పుడు ఏం చేయాలి? లెట్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ ఓన్లీ డేట్, విత్ ఇన్ దిస్ ఐ షుడ్ నాట్ మిస్ ద డెల్టా రికార్డ్స్, వాట్ కెన్ ఐ డూ? అంటే కాసు అర్థం కాదు. సో కెన్ ఐ సే ఇఫ్ ఐమ్ నాట్ సపోజ్ టు మిస్ ఎనీ రికార్డ్, ఐ మస్ట్ రన్ డెల్టా ఓన్లీ వన్స్ పర్ డే, దట్ అట్ ది ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది క్లాక్, 12 o'clock రన్ చేసాను అనుకో, అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది? ఆఫ్టర్ 12 o'clock ఈ కెనాట్ ఎనీ ఆఫ్ క్రియేట్ రికార్డ్స్. ఇఫ్ యూ క్రియేట్స్ ఇట్ విల్ బీ నెక్స్ట్ డే. అప్పుడు ఏమంటే వెన్ ఎవర్ ఐ సెట్అప్ డెల్టా అండ్ క్యాల్డే టు నాట్ టు మిస్ ద డెల్టా రికార్డ్స్, ఐ హావ్ టు రన్ డెల్టా ఓన్లీ వన్స్ అట్ ఎండ్ ఆఫ్ ది క్లాక్, 12 o'clock రాత్రి రన్ చేయాలి. అట్లా 10 ఉన్నాయనుకో, అన్ని 10-12 గంటలు రన్ చేయొచ్చా? కెన్ ఇఫ్ ఐ హావ్ 100 ఎక్స్ట్రాక్టర్స్, కెన్ ఐ రన్ ది ఇన్ఫో ప్యాస్ ఫర్ 100 ఎక్స్ట్రాక్టర్స్ ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ 12 o'clock? ఐ మే నాట్ బి రైట్, మే నాట్ వర్క్అవుట్. సో అప్పుడు ఏం చేస్తామంటే, సో వీ కెనాట్ రియలీ గ్యారంటీ దట్ ఇట్ ఆల్వేస్ రన్స్ అట్ 12 o'clock ఓన్లీ. దేర్ మైట్ బి ఐ మిస్ అవుట్, సో వేరే లోడ్ ఏదో లేట్ అయింది, నాది లేట్ అయిపోయింది, ఇట్ కెన్ బి పాసిబుల్ లైక్ దట్. సో what they do, they cannot really depend on the timing when the load runs in. So appude em chestamante, there is a concept called safety lower limit and concept. Safety lower limit attended. Now what is actual lower limit now? 24th kada, then one day eniki jaripetko ippudu prathisari anta. Then what happens when the lower limit is 24, actual criteria should be greater than 24 and less than or equal to 25. ఐ వుడ్ సే లోవర్ లిమిట్ ఆఫ్ వన్ డే అంటే, అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది? 24 ఇస్ మూవ్డ్ బ్యాక్ టు 23rd, సో గ్రేటర్ దాన్ 23rd అండ్ లెస్ దాన్ 25, అప్పుడు ఆ రికార్డ్ వస్తుందా? అప్పుడు ఇంకో వేరే ప్రాబ్లం ఉంటుంది, అప్పుడు ఏమవుతుంది? డూప్లికేట్స్ వచ్చే ఛాన్స్ ఉంది. ఐ ల్యాండ్ ఇన్ దోస్, ఓకే, ఐఎమ్ ట్రై టు మిస్ ద ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ మిస్సింగ్ డెల్టా రికార్డ్స్, సమ్ డూప్లికేట్ రికార్డ్స్ ఇస్ ఫైన్, ఇన్స్ ఆఫ్ బ్రింగింగ్ ఎంటర్ డూప్లికేట్స్, సమ్ రికార్డ్స్ డూప్లికేట్ ఇస్ ఓకే, ఐ విల్ హ్యాండిల్ ఇట్ బై ఓవర్ రైటింగ్ ఇన్ ది ఓడిఎస్. అది లో సేఫ్టీ లిమిట్, సేఫ్టీ లోవర్ లిమిట్స్. అర్థమైందన్నా? బట్ యాక్చువల్లీ వీ హ్యాడ్ దిస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ బికాస్ ఐ వాజ్ నాట్ యూజింగ్ టైమ్ కదా. but I can still handle it by using what? Safety, lower limits like this. Clear this? That is one. And same thing if you go with date and time, let's say 10 o'clock. Let's say it's 22nd. If it is date and time together, what is it you call it as? Yeah, time stamp as. Let's say there are two records now, okay. Now since I have timestamp, yeah, I have a field called timestamp which gives me created timestamp or change timestamp. I will set up delta. What type of delta now? Timestamp year, date and time together. Yeah. I will set up timestamp delta by using this field now. Okay, let's say now the time is 9 o'clock on the same day. I create two records, okay, 8 o'clock and 8:10. Let's say when you run it, load at 9 o'clock, what happens? It extracts these two and then takes it to what? BW, and it sets the time. Time as what? What is it now? When did you run the delta? Okay, it was 9 o'clock. Let's say after 9 o'clock, you start still creating transactions on the same day. I plan to run delta every 1 hour. You can also do it every half an hour, okay. Let's say next, now the time is 10 o'clock. So what is the criteria? 90 bit, sorry. What is the criteria first? Lower limit is 9 o'clock, upper limit is 10 o'clock. So greater than 9, less than or equal to 10. So it extracts what? Will it extract these records between 9 and 10? And it updates the status as what now? 10 o'clock. Like this, can I do delta lots multiple times a day because I got timestamp available, time available. Clear this? But again, I might have some problem here. Look. So, you plan to run delta every 1 hour, right? So, already delta 10 o'clock is run. When will be next delta? After 1 hour, time 11 o'clock. Right? Let's say exactly at 10:57. Exactly at 10:57, I started creating a transaction. When I say create new transaction, I would get a transaction screen where it will take the current date and time in it. What will be current date and time? April 22nd, 9:57 as the date. Okay, and I'll do all the transactions. 11 o'clock delta runs in, but there are no records. It will bring zero, but it will update. Will it update the status as what? 11 o'clock. At 11:05, customer had some coffee, then he just saved it transaction at 11:05. At 11:05, the document comes into this table with what time? It will come with 10:57, but what time will this record comes in? At 11 o'clock. And sir, 11:05 lo save chesina. Okay. So next delta will run at what? 12 o'clock. When at 12, the criteria should be what? Lower limit is 11 o'clock. Difference between 11 and 12, what record will come? There is no record comes in. I am not missing this record. Yeah? Why? He took lot of time to post. So, if I need to make sure that there is no delta record missed out, I must say that every user will do posting in 2 minutes only. Understand? We cannot guarantee it. But still, if I want to reduce the chance of missing delta records, okay, half an hour, 1 hour వెనక్కి పోగలిగితే కనెక్ట్ రెడ్యూస్ ద ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ మిస్సింగ్. అగైన్ వచ్చి సేఫ్టీ లోవర్ లిమిట్ ఆఫ్ లెట్స్ హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ 300 సెకండ్స్. హాఫ్ అన్ అవర్ అంటే సే 1800 సెకండ్స్ ఉంటాం, అంటే 30 మినిట్స్ ఇట్ గోస్ బ్యాక్. సో ఇన్స్ ఆఫ్ 11 and 10 ఇట్ సేస్ 10:30 to 12. అవర్ మళ్ళీ డూప్లికేట్ కార్డ్ దేర్ ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ డూప్లికేట్ ఐ కెన్ ఓవర్ రైట్ దట్ విత్ వాట్ ఓడిఎస్ నువ్వు అనాల్ దర్ ఇస్ అ యూజర్ హూ స్టార్ట్ క్రియేటింగ్ అట్ లెట్స్ సే 7:59 ఈ సేవ్డ్ ఆఫ్టర్ 2 డేస్ ఉంటాడు. ఎస్ దెర్ కుడ్ బి పాసిబుల్ లైక్ బట్ వాట్ ఐమ్ సేయింగ్ ఇస్ బై యూజింగ్ సేఫ్టీ లోవర్ లిమిట్స్ ఐ మోల్ రెడ్యూసింగ్ ది ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ మిస్సింగ్ డెల్టా రికార్డ్స్ బట్ ఐ కెనాట్ గ్యారంటీ 100% గ్యారంటీ లేదన్న మ్యాక్సిమం పాసిబిలిటీ తగ్గిస్తున్నా, దట్స్ వాట్ ఐఎమ్ క్యాన్. ఓకే నంబర్స్ ఫైన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ డెల్టా విత్ క్యాల్డే టైమ్ స్టాంప్ న్యూమరిక్ పాయింటర్ తప్పదు మిస్ అయ్యింది. వీ కెన్ ఓన్లీ రెడ్యూస్ ద ఛాన్స్ ఆఫ్ మిస్సింగ్ రికార్డ్స్, వీ కెనాట్ రియల్లీ గ్యారంటీ సరే అబ్బా సెటప్ చేసినాక ఎప్పటికి తీసుకుంటారంటే ఎవడు చేయలేడు. అట్లాంటి వాడు ఏమంటే నేను సంవత్సరం తర్వాత సేవ్ చేస్తా అంటాడు. అప్పుడు ఇట్స్ బెటర్ యూ డూ ఫుల్ అప్లోడ్. ఓకే సో దిస్ ఆర్ యూ దెనేబుల్ డెల్టా. సో లెట్స్ యూర్ పర్ఫార్మింగ్ జెనరిక్ ఎక్స్ట్రాక్టర్, లెట్స్ యూ కెన్ గో టేబుల్ వ్యూ ఇన్ఫో ఎనీథింగ్ యూ వాంట్ డిపెండింగ్ ఆన్ ద ఫీల్డ్స్ వాట్ ఇస్. సపోజ్ ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ గివెన్ విత్ అ కౌంటర్ లైక్ ఫీల్డ్ అండ్ వేర్ దిస్ ఆల్వేస్ క్రియేషన్ ఆఫ్ న్యూ రికార్డ్ యూ ఎనేబుల్ డెల్టా న్యూమరిక్ పాయింట్. So if I give you like change date which tells me on which date this particular transaction is being created or change date, then I can enable delta on date, cal date. If I have timestamp field, I can go with what timestamp delta. I don't have counter like field, I don't have change date, I don't have change timestamp, then what? Yoda in jail, full of good buttons. I don't have an option of enabling it with numeric pointer because there is no counter like field. There is no date or change date. There is no change timestamp through which I can recognize because there should be some logic through which I can recognize. Only then I can explain the system what to do. If I don't know the logic, if I can't derive a logic to identify, system cannot derive it. So, there will be only option of doing what? Full. There could be scenario in the real time where they are not able to enable delta, it will be only full loads also. Day to timestamp pointer, aim, nothing is available, then you will have to do what? Full upload. Okay? See, I have this table already. Yeah? I got the table with these 4 fields. So these are the document numbers. 13 I've got. Okay, boss, fine. I'll enable delta first on what else? VBLN using what? Numeric pointer. I don't need any safety upper limit, lower limit, anything. Now there's 2 radio buttons options now. New status for change records or delta. If I say new status for change records, let's say there is a document with 8 rupees, 8, 8, 8, and then you change it to 10. It only gives me change in value. Only 10 comes in. Then I need to what? Override the data. If I say add it to delta, it can give you only difference. 8 is changed to 10, it gives you what? The 2. Then I can add up to my queue. So I'm going with new status for change records and then say what? Save. Then what? So save. I have now, does it enable delta? Yes. Then what should I do? Replicate. Today is my this one or this one? BW connection, right? Because I'm using extractor in this. This one Z demo, yeah? Change. Now just understand, just see there's something. What is here? Yeah, I'll explain that later. But if you want, you can connect to the DS1 and then load. But I'm not loading now because I just want to show you delta with info package. I don't need target, because when I run info, it only comes till data source, right? I don't need target now. Only OS load JS, OS bit transformations are better. I'm not doing it. I only want to show you those delta coming in. Yeah? Can I just create info package here and show you? Because if I want to load it to the target, then I need ODS also. I'm not loading, I'm just want to see the delta. Yeah. Extraction, processing, what do you do? See, now you get to see these two options. Since your data source enables delta, you start getting to see this option, initialize delta process. Init with the data, without data. I would like to initialize, means enable for delta with by bringing historical data. Schedule and say what? Start. How many records I had in the table? 13 records. So as an init, we should bring in historical records, should bring in all those 13. Successfully done. If init is successfully done, two things should happen. One is, in the info package, you start, refresh your screen. Do you start getting to see delta? If you disturb JGO and NGS, generally, they try to copy this info package and they'll say, they'll not disturb, because that should be like that as a proof that init was run. Init run is not, settings are clear, but saving. And then they get into this, they say it what? Delta, and you can start running it. This is first change you should see once you run in it. Then should I see delta status? Yes or no? Yeah? Where do you see delta status? RSS 7. What is your data source bus? Z demo, right? And if you get to the last corner, what is this? Pointer first, not a status, okay. Just click on this. Status on which field? V billion. And what is present status bus? Document number 13. That is what status is. Okay. Shall I create one more record? Okay, now it's done. I'll go back to middle, I'll run my delta. How many cuts will come? Can I see this in the PSA? What are the two records? Ante na code is work also like that, na? I can observe here also, 14 and 15. Okay. Do you understand this? Now you should see the status, getting it as, minus Z demo, right? Getting it to what? What a status update I found. This is what we discussed in the Excel, yeah? Okay. Does this table give me date like stuff? Yeah, can I use that? Anni my current date, my system current date emundo naaku telundi now please. Okay. calded delta on which field now? Here delta. And can I say, if you want to go one day back always, can I say safety lower limit as what? One, when it is calded, it indicates days. If you select timestamp, one indicate what? 1 second actually, okay? So it will go one day back, yeah? So now as it is in it, brings in 15 records. Yes. Okay, now let's see the status in the delta key. What is Z demo date? 12-2-2014. What I'll go to this table, create. One second. Some 16. So my status is 12, right? It said limit of 1. So it goes one day back and then can exit. So if it is goes one day back, should it pick even a save value? 13 and so you have 13, 14. If it goes one day back, even all these four records should bring it up. What is the option you select? It is not recognizing that. Why? The problem here is, what is the criteria when you run delta date wise? Greater than the previous timestamp. Previous lower limit and current date, right? Current date is still 12 only. So tomorrow when we run the load, it picks up records with 12 and what? 13. My system date program 12 on, so always upper limit is current date. That's the problem. Yes, there's two options. You don't see why I'm not, why it's not getting 13 and 14. My system date is 12, so upper limit is what? 12. What is it? And I wanted to read this information. If you go in, there is upper limit, right? Just keep cursor on this and save one. You read this. You'll give a very good example. 1125 created, 1135 saved, and what will happen? Read that, okay? Upper limit. Then there's something lower limit. Read this. Can you try to read this? If you don't understand, read twice, you get the same thing what we discussed. If you're saving at 1057 and saving at 115, like this. okay, this is about generic deltas. Okay,